victory we are with, achieved by the sacrifices which will have purified us, as they will have glorified our cause.
Thank you. It will not be pleasant listening. If you're at lunch, or if you have no appetite to hear what Germans have done, now is a good time to switch off the radio. For I propose to tell you of Buchenwald. It is on a small hill about 4 miles outside Weimar, and it was one of the largest concentration camps in Germany, and it was built to last. In another part of the camp, they showed me the children, hundreds of them. Some were only six. One rolled up his sleeve, showed me his number. It was tattooed on his arm. B-6030 it was. The others showed me their number. They will carry them till they die. An elderly man standing beside me said, "The children, enemies of the state." I could see their ribs through their thin shirts. The old man said, "I am Professor Charles Richet of the Sorbonne." The children clung to my hands and stared. We crossed to the courtyard. Men kept coming up to speak to me and to touch me. Professors from Poland, doctors from Vienna, men from all Europe. Men from the countries that made America. I pray you to believe what I have said about Buchenwald. I have reported what I saw and heard. But only part of it. For most of it, I have no words. Dead men are plentiful in war. But the living dead, more than 20,000 of them in one camp. And the country round about was pleasing to the eye. And the Germans were well fed and well dressed. American trucks were rolling towards the rear, filled with prisoners. Soon they would be eating American rations. As much for a meal as the men at Buchenwald received in 4 days.
Thank you. Vi kan blanda och göra en kyrka.